The year is 1991. Pan Am closes down after 64 years as one of the nation's leading airlines. Clarence Thomas is confirmed as a Supreme Court justice despite accusations of sexual harassment by Anita Hill. And grunge enters the national vocabulary as Nirvana's album Nevermind hits the charts and the single Smells Like Teen Spirit becomes a massive success. Also massively successful in 1991 was Microsoft as it launched new subsidiaries in Venezuela, Hong Kong, New Zealand, Mexico, Austria, Argentina, and Thailand. An expansion results in a makeover of sorts. On February 1, 1991, Microsoft announces a major redesign of product packaging to include the new Windows flag logo. This is, however, not the four-colored flag, but the first Windows-compatible mark. Later that month, on February 25th, it is revealed that 21 computer manufacturers have announced their intentions to build pen-based computers that will support the Microsoft Windows for Pen Computing, or Windows for Pens. In early March, Microsoft reports an agreement to acquire the assets of Consumers Software, Inc. These assets include the Network Courier product line for PC local area networks. On March 8, 1991, a toll-free piracy hotline number is established for consumer reports or inquiries about pirated software products, the creatively spelled 1-800-NOCOPYN. Days later, on March 11th, Microsoft announces the ballpoint mouse, designed especially for use with laptop computers. Students everywhere rejoice on March 18th when Microsoft announces the Microsoft Bookshelf for Windows on CD-ROM. Now, Bookshelf is a core set of reference materials for the home, office, or school that is run on a personal computer. But that wasn't the only Microsoft move made on the 18th. The company also purchases a 26% share of Dorling Kindersley Ltd. It's a London-based book publisher and international packager. As part of the agreement, the Microsoft Multimedia Publishing Group gains rights to license content from Dorling Kindersley for use in future multimedia software titles. And on the same day, Microsoft announces that along with 11 other companies, it plans to use a special MPC trademark to indicate to customers that hardware products and system software bearing the mark are compatible with the previously announced multimedia PC specification. The month of March closes with good news for Microsoft. On the 25th, sales of software applications written for Windows 3.0 skyrocket. Newly released Software Publishers Association data for the year end of 1990 shows a 157% increase in sales of Windows applications in both the US and Canada. Later that spring, on May 10th, Microsoft's aggressive anti-piracy campaign gets a new slogan, "Work with the Original." Logos, artwork, posters, brochures, and marketing programs and events will all emphasize the advantages of working with legitimate software, both domestically and internationally. On May 20th, there's even more big news, as Microsoft announces Visual Basic for Windows at Windows World 1991 in Atlanta, Georgia.
Well, this isn't the biggest show of the year, but it's the only one with three keynote speeches. This first Windows World is dedicated to those of you who supported Windows since its introduction back in 1983. I had an opportunity to go out on the show floor last night and look around at some of the new things that are going on. And it was fun to have developers come up to me and talk to me about their applications. Several of them describe things they're doing with Windows that I wouldn't have even imagined would be possible. And a number of them talked about the great sales that they're having of their applications.
But that's only the first of two major software announcements. The second comes on June 11th when Microsoft announces the immediate availability of Microsoft MS-DOS 5.0.
Speed. Take five.
Cue them.
You never know when it will happen. Your DOS applications demand more memory. We want to move between applications like that. A And you want to move files between directories just as fast. You're in a hurry to edit a text file, and you haven't quite mastered Edlib. What do? Or you trash a file by mistake. What do you do? What do you do? Get MS-DOS 5. No PC should be without it.
3 days later, Microsoft is finally connected to the nationwide TCP/IP-based internet. It's a sign of big things to come. At the height of summer on July 8th, the company announces that a product support service site will be opened in Dallas, Texas in October of 91. The new Dallas site will be headed by Glenn Young, who will report to Patty Stonecipher. A familiar and very useful app makes its debut on August 5th. Microsoft Wizards will allow Microsoft applications to anticipate what a user will do next or suggest a better way to accomplish the task. The technology would enable the program to follow a user's movements as she or he works and draw a conclusion as to what the user is apt to do next. By the end of August, Excel 3.0 for Windows is generating significant gains in market share and a groundswell of support from software developers and corporate customers. Microsoft ships 1.5 million units of Excel worldwide, and 40% of the increased market share of Excel comes from users who are switching to Excel from competitive spreadsheet packages. On September 16th, Microsoft releases the Solution Series. It's a collection of standalone task-oriented applications designed for the personal and small business computer user. The applications include Works for Windows, Money, and Publisher. Now, all these apps run under Windows 3.0 and are designed for people who are new to personal computing and those who don't want to spend a lot of extra time playing around with their computers. November 1st turns out to be the date of Microsoft's second big makeover of the year. At Fall Comdex 91, Microsoft announces the new and now familiar Microsoft Windows logo, a colorful window with trailing rectangular tails in the shape of a fluttering flag. It's intended to be displayed on products that are compatible with versions 3.0 and 3.1 of Windows. Days later, November 8th, Microsoft workers demonstrate their generosity. For the first time, employees contribute more than $1 million to the United Way campaign. With Microsoft's dollar-for-dollar corporate match, the 1991 donation comes to more than $2 million. As the year comes to a close, Microsoft has one final announcement: open database connectivity that allows applications to communicate easily with both relational and non-relational management systems. It's based on the SQL Access Group's call level interface specification, which uses SQL to access database environments. In 1991, Terminator 2, Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves, and Silence of the Lambs dominate the box office, and Microsoft continued to dominate sales. 91 has been a wildly successful year for the corporation, which sees a fiscal year-end sales totaling excess of $1,843,000,000. Additionally, 91 sees the employee headcount balloon to over 8,000 people. But as the internet begins to gradually establish itself, how will Microsoft ride the coming online wave?